So the next point we will discuss in the error detection and correction is that is the checksum. So in the checksum, the checksum is the last error detection method. Okay. So here we discuss that last error detection method is we have to call as a that is the checksum. Okay. The checksum is used in the internet by the several protocol, although not at a data link layer. Okay. This particular checksum is mainly you have to use in the internet. Okay. We have to use in the data link layer. Okay. So here the checksum is nothing but it is one of the last error detection method. Okay. It is mainly we have to use it in the internet, not in the any data link layer. Okay. So now we'll discuss the what is a checksum. Okay. More about that. So checksum is nothing but here what the first point. So at the source, the message is first divided into the m bits. Okay. The message we need to divide into the m bits. It means you need to divide the message into the 4 bits, or you need to divide the message into 8 bit or 16 bit. Okay, when it is 4 bit, the m is equal to 4. Okay, the next point is at the generator, then create the extra m bit units called checksum, which sent with the message. Okay, so again we need to create the checksum here. The checksum is also same size as that of the message size. Okay. If you are using the 4 bits to represent the message, those 4 bits you have to also use to represent the checksum. Okay. Message size and checksum size will be same. Okay. So that's why the generator create the extra m bit unit called that is a checksum. So that we need to send along with the message. Okay. So checksum is nothing but what here? First, you need to divide the message into the m bits. Okay, then again you need to create the extra m bit unit. That what we have to call as a checksum. That checksum we need to send along with the message. 4 bit message is there, then you need to create the 4 bit checksum. That we need to send along with the message. Okay, the checksum we have to use for the error detection purpose. Next, we'll discuss the one's complement addition. Okay, so in the first point is in this arithmetic we can represent the unsigned number between the 0 to 2 raised to m minus 1 using only m bits. Okay, so if you are using the 4 bit to represent the numbers, okay, if a number means it is a data or what we are sending to the receiver. Okay, if you are using the 4 bit, okay, to represent the number, okay, then how many numbers we can represent by using the 4 bit? That is between the 0 to 2 raised to m minus 1. Okay, if m is here nothing but 4, 2 raised to 4 minus 1 means it is 16 minus 1 means 15. Means by using the 4 bits, you can represent the 0 to 15 numbers by using the 4 bits. Okay, so that is the what meaning of this definition. In this arithmetic, we can represent the unsigned number between the 0 to 2 raised to m minus 1 using only m bits. M is 4 means we can only represent 15 numbers by using the 4 bit. Okay. And next point is here, if the number has more than m bits, the extra leftmost bit we need to add to the m rightmost bits. Okay. That we will see how we to do that. Okay. By using one example. Okay. So we will see that example. So here, how to calculate the checksum at the sender side, okay? So here, what we have to doing, we have to sending here 5 4 bit numbers we have to sending to the receiver, okay? So here totally 5 numbers are there, okay? All those 5 numbers are the 4 bit numbers, means all these numbers we can represent it by using the 4 binary bits. Okay, so that's why we have to sending 5 4 bit numbers to the receiver. Okay, so initially what we have to do, we have to initialize the checksum as equal to 0. Means initially you have to take the checksum as the 0 here, the colored number that is a 0. Okay, initially we have to take the checksum value has been 0. Okay, and After that, the second step is we have to add the all those PIU numbers. PIU numbers means including the checksum, we have to add the numbers. Okay, so here we need to add all these six numbers, all these five numbers, also including the checksum. Okay, so what is the value we will get? 36. Okay, so that 36 we need to include into the that particular data, that is a 36. Okay, but what is the problem here? That 36 we can represent it by using the 6-bit binary number. Okay, but here what happened? The remaining numbers has been 4-bit number, but the 36 has been 6-bit number. Okay, so that's why you need to convert that 6-bit number into the 4-bit. Okay, so that is the next step here. Third step, by using the ones complement addition or the ones complement arithmetic, we need to convert that 6-bit number into the 4-bit. Okay, so that is the second point what we have discussed here. If the number has more than m bits, it is more than m bits, 4 bits are there, but there is a 6-bit more than 4 bits. Okay, then the extra leftmost bits we need to add to the m rightmost bits. Means here, what is the extra leftmost bits in this? For that you need to take the two leftmost bits here. Okay, you have to take the two leftmost bits. Okay, that is a 10. If you remove that 10, then the remaining will be the 4-bit number. Okay, so that's why the 10 is an extra leftmost, because present at the left side, so that's why it is the extra leftmost bits. Okay, that we need to add to the m rightmost bits. M means the 4-bit the 4-bit rightmost numbers, that is a 0100, that is a 0100. Okay, we need to add to convert a 6-bit number into the 4-bit. So here addition means we need to perform the XOR operation. Performing the XOR operation, we will get the 4-bit binary number, that is 0110. Okay, so in the decimal we can represent as a 6. Okay, 6 is nothing but what? Here we have to using the 4-bit number. Okay, 2^m-1 means only we can represent the 15 numbers by using the 4 bits. Okay, so that is the 6 is also less than 15, means the 6 can be also we can represent it by using the 4 bits. Okay, so that 4-bit, that 6 we need to include into the data at the place of 36. Okay, so that is a third step, one complement addition. Why we have to do the ones complement addition? When the number of bits which are more than the m bits, means so here, okay, the number has more than m bits. Okay, then we need to perform the ones complement addition, because here 36 has a 6 bits, that is more than the 4 bits. Okay, that's why we need to do the one complement addition. How we do the one complement addition? Take the leftmost bits, okay, extra leftmost bit, that we need to add to the rightmost bits. Then we'll get the 4 bit binary number. Okay, then we'll get the 4-bit binary number that we need to convert into decimal, and after converting the decimal we need to include that 6 into the data. Okay, and the fourth step is here, need to take the complement of that particular 6. Okay, complement of that 6 means first we have to take the binary form of that particular 6, 0110. So we need to complement that binary numbers. Means complement means we need to convert the all zeros into the 1 and all 1 into the 0. Okay, so here 0 is converted into 1, and these two 1 are converted into, these two 1s are converted into the 0 0, and last 0 has been converted into the 1. That is complement, means inverting the all 0 to the 1 and all 1 to the 0. Okay, so then we'll get the 1001. So you need to represent in the decimal. The decimal value will be the 9. Okay, so this 9 has been final checksum that we need to add into the include into the data. Okay, so that is the final data we need to send to the receiver, 7, 11, 12, 0, 6 and 9 as a checksum. Okay, so in this way you need to calculate the checksum value. Okay, we need to calculate the checksum value. First we need to initialize the checksum as being 0. Okay, and after that we in the second step we need to add the all 5 numbers including this 0, that is the checksum. So what we will get, 36, but 36 has a 6 bit number, but all the remaining numbers has 4 bit number. So that's why you need to convert the 6 bit to the 4 bit. So that's why in the third step we have to use the ones complement addition or the ones complement arithmetic. So what is meaning of that? Here extra leftmost bits. Okay, so the extra leftmost bit we need to add to the rightmost bit of that binary. Okay, so that's the 10 is the extra leftmost bits and rightmost bits are 0100. Okay, we need to add those and we will get the 4 bit binary number that we need to convert it into the decimal. After converting that into the decimal, we need to include it into the data. Okay, and in the fourth step we need to take the complement. After taking a complement we will get the 9. 9 is a final checksum and that we need to add into the data. Okay, so this is the data we need to send to the receiver that has been include the checksum value 9. Okay, so now we'll discuss what will be happen at the receiver side. Okay, so at the receiver side, the first step is here. Okay, it will add the all the 5 bits. Okay, so at the receiver side it will add the all the 5 bits including the checksum. Okay, it will add the all the 5 bit including this checksum, that is the first step. Okay, so what value will get adding the all the 5 bits including the checksum? That is a 45. Okay, the 45 is an 6 bit number. Okay, but all the remaining numbers are the 4 bit number, so that's why again here we need to apply the ones complement addition to convert that 6 bit number into the 4 bit. So again you have to take the extra leftmost bits. Okay, so that is a 10 is the extra leftmost bits that we need to take here. Okay, and remaining 4 bits and the remaining 4 rightmost bit we have to take the second addition value. Okay, so that is a 10 plus 1101. You need to perform the addition. Means addition means here is nothing but the you need to perform the XOR operation between the two words. Okay, after that we will get the 4 bit binary numbers, that is a 1111. So that is converted into the decimal. So after converting the decimal we will get the 15. Okay, so again we have to take the complement of that 15. So first we have to represent into the binary. Okay, here we need to invert all 1 into the 0 and all 0 into the 1. Okay, so here all 1s are present, so we need to convert it into the 0. So 0 is a complement of the 15. Okay, so if you take the decimal value is also 0. Okay, so the complement of 15 is 0. Okay, so that is a fourth step. Is if final result has been 0 means data has been not corrupted. If final value is non-0 then data has been corrupted. Okay, so this is at the receiver side. Okay, so what has been happening at the receiver side here? Okay, first we need to add the all the 5 bit including the checksum, that will get the 45 that has been represented by using 6 bit, but remainings are 4 bit number. So again in the second step we have to use the ones complement addition to convert that 6 bit into the 4 bit. Okay, so that's why we have to take extra leftmost bits, that is a 10. Okay, and that we need to add into the 4 bit a right most numbers, that is a 1 1, 1 1 0 1, okay, 1 1 0 1 and 1 0. We need to perform the XOR operation between that and we will get the binary number as a 1 1 1, okay. That we need to convert into the decimal, that is a 15, okay. And in the third step we need to take the complement of that 15, that we need to represent it into the 15, we need to first represent into the binary numbers, okay. And after representing the binary numbers, we have to take the complement of that binary number, okay. Means all in the complement we need to invert all the 1 into the 0 and all 0 to the 1. So here all 1s are there, so that's why we need to invert into the 0, okay. So this 0, if you converted into the decimal, then you will get the value as a 0, okay. So if the final result has been 0, means data has been not corrupted, okay. If the final value has been not 0, then data has been corrupted, okay. So in this way you need to calculate the checksum, and by using that checksum at the receiver side you need to detect the error, okay. So here they have given the whole those calculation you have to given in the two box, okay. So here what happened? So at the sender side we have to use the 7, 11, 12, 0, 6 as a 5 bit number. Initially we have to take the checksum value as a 0, okay. And you need to add all these numbers, okay. We will get the 36. 36 cannot be represented into the 4 bit number. That is a 6 bit number. So that's why you need to convert it into the 4 bit by using the 1's complement addition or the 1's complement arithmetic, then we will get the 4 bit number, that is a 6, and 6 we need to complement, we will get the 9, okay. That 9 we need to add into the data, that is a checksum, final checksum, and we have to send to the receiver. At the receiver side it will add the all these 5 numbers including the checksum, okay. Then we will get the value as a 45. Okay, 45 is a 6 bit number, so that 6 bit number we need to convert into the 4 bit by using the 1's complement, okay. So after that we will get the value as a 15, okay. And at the final we need to take the complement of that 15, then we will get the 0, that is a final checksum, okay. If we will get the checksum at the receiver side, if we will get the checksum value as a 0, means data has been not corrupted. If you will get the non-zero value, then data has been corrupted, okay. So this is a overall representation of the how we have to use the checksum to detect the errors, okay. So next we have to discuss the internet checksum. Internet checksum is nothing but the here in the previous what happened, we have to dividing the message into the 4 bits. In the internet checksum we have to divide the message into the, means internet checksum means here we have to use the, or we have to divide the message into the 16 bit, okay. Previously we have to dividing the message into the 4 bits, and in the internet checksum we have to divide the message into the 16 bit, okay. So they have given here sender site, okay. They have given the sender side here and the receiver side, means what are the operation will be happen at the sender side and what are the operation will be happen at the receiver side, okay. So we have discussed already this message is divided into the 16 bit. In the previous we have to dividing the message into the 4 bits, here you have to divide the message into the 16 bit, okay. And next is the value of the checksum word is set to the 0. So as previously you know, value we need to set to the, initialize the value to the 0, okay. And third one is all words including the checksum are added using the 1's complement, means we need to add the all those numbers including the checksum, initial checksum value, okay. Then after that we will get the number which has more than the 4 bit as we discussed previously. If that is more than 4 bit, then again we need to perform the 1's complement addition, then we will get the 4 bit number. Same thing here also, all the words including the checksum are added by using the 1's complement addition, okay. And after that the sum is complemented, so at the final the sum has been complemented, that is a 1's complement sum, we have to invert or complement, okay, the 6 has been complemented to 9, same thing here, the sum is complemented, and that becomes the final checksum, and that checksum is sent with the data. Okay, so at the receiver side, same what we have discussed previously, the message and checksums are received. Okay, message along with checksums are received here. That message is divided into the 16 bit. Okay, and all the words including the checksum are added, means whatever checksum along with the remaining numbers we need to add. Okay, so as we discussed, okay, all those numbers including the checksum we need to add. Okay, if you get the number which is more than the m bits, in the previously there is a 4 bit, it is more than the 4 bit, then again we need to convert into the 4 bits by using the ones complement addition. Okay, so after converting into the 4 bits or the m bits, okay, in the next step we need to complement that sum. Okay, and that sum, the complemented sum will become the new checksum. The new checksum has been 0 at the receiver side in the previous. Okay, so if the value of the checksum has been 0, then message is accepted, otherwise it will be rejected. Okay, so as we discussed in the previous examples, what are the operation we need to do at the sender side, what are the operation we need to do at the receiver side, the same thing they are mentioned here, the sender side and the receiver side. Okay, so this is the algorithm. Okay, so here, so this is the algorithm. So here first we need to start with the sum equal to 0, means we have to initialize the checksum is equal to 0. Okay, and after that this is a rectangle. Okay, this diamond shaped symbol has been represents the loop. Okay, so in that loop sum is equal to sum plus next word. Okay, so sum has been initially 0, so next word has been, here you have to take the sum has been 0, first you have to take the first word, that is a 7. Okay, so the first word has been 7, the 7 plus 0, 7, the new sum value. Okay, again the loop will goes back. Okay, again there is a more words are there, yes, then again the loop will be continue, again it will take the next word. Okay, so next word here is 11. Okay, so it will take the 11 plus previous sum value. Okay, previous sum value has been 7, 11 plus 7, 18, now it will be 18. So again the loop will goes back. Okay, again you will check there is a more some other words are there. Okay, so here that again words are there, there is a next word has been 12. Okay, so that 12 we have to, again we have to add into the sum. Okay, 18 plus 12, 30. Okay, so this will be continue until all words has been over, including the checksum. Okay, so whatever the final sum will come. Okay, so whenever there is a no words are present, this loop will be terminate. Okay, so that will get the final sum value. Okay, and we need to move to the next loop. Okay, so after getting the final sum, so here you need to check whether that is a m bit number or more than m bit number. Okay, more than m bit number, then we need to do the one complement addition. Okay, so here we need to do the one complement addition by taking the leftmost bits and the rightmost bits, that they have given here, left sum and the right sum. Okay, so here you have to take the left sum as a, okay, left sum as a 10 and right sum as a 0100. Okay, so 10 plus 0100 as a right sum. Okay, so that we need to add and we will get the ones complement sum. Okay, and that we need to pass to the next step, that here we need to take the complement of that particular sum. Okay, so in the previous we have got the value as a 6, and after that we have to take the complement of that. Okay, same thing here also, after getting that value we need to do the complement of sum, and after that we need to truncate that particular checksum. Okay, because here we have to using the 16 bit. Okay, so that's why you need to that particular checksum we need to truncate into the 16 bit, and that will be end the algorithm. Okay, so in this way this particular algorithm will represent, first we need to initialize a checksum into the 0, and after that we need to add the all the numbers including the checksum. If it is more than m bits, then you have to perform the ones complement addition, I mean taking the left sum and the right sum, okay, and after that we have to complement the sum after the ones complement addition, okay, that we need to complement that particular ones complemented sum, okay, and next we have to truncate the sum into the 16 bit. Because it is a 16 bit here we are using, so that's why you need to truncate into the 16 bit. Okay, so here they have given that word checksum or each as a 16 bit. They are using the 16 bit. After doing the addition, we'll get the 32 bit. So we need to bring that 32 bit into the 16 bit. So that's why you need to perform calculate the left sum and the right sum. So here the left sum they have performed by shifting the 16 bit to the right, okay, and right sum they are performing the AND operation between the sum and this particular value, that is 40 and 4F. Why you are to using 4F means, for F is nothing but the 15, 15 can be represented by the 4 ones, okay, so there is a 4F are there, so that is a 16 bit. Okay, so that's why we have to take this 4F, and after the checksum we need to truncate into the 16 bit. Okay, so this is the what algorithm it is represent. Okay, so we have discussed the 4 bit number, so here we have to use the 16 bit instead of 4 bits. That is the only difference. Okay, so that's will end the checksum.